So I've got this friend at work, and for the sake of this video, let's call him Dan. I've mentioned him before in at least one of my videos. He's a huge Leave It To Beaver fan. Anyway, the other day he said to me, "Dude, you've got to do something on Gus the Fireman." And the moment he said it, I knew he was right. Maybe not necessarily a video all about Gus the Fireman, but rather a video about the absolutely amazing actor who played him, Burt Mustin. Born in 1884, yes, you heard me correctly, 1884, Mustin graduated from the Pennsylvania Military College in 1903. He was a great student and a pretty darn good collegiate athlete as well. After school, Mustin traveled and for a brief period of time worked in Memphis, where he met and married Robina Woods, to whom he would refer to as his darling Bine. He did that in 1915. They would remain married for over 50 years until her passing in 1969. So at this point, you're saying to yourself, what's so amazing about this guy? Well, here's the thing. You see, although Burt was a multi-talented chap, he really had no idea that he would ever become one of Hollywood's great character actors. Because after graduating from school with a civil engineering degree, Burt toyed around with the idea of becoming an engineer, and he also pondered the possibilities of joining his father's brokerage firm. However, end of the day, what really happened was for the next 25 years, Mustin was a car salesman. And with the advent of World War II, automobile production was halted in the US, and so for a time at least, he became a salesman for hearing aids. At age 60, Mustin and his wife moved to the warmer climate of Tucson, Arizona because of her failing health. It was there that he rediscovered a passion for acting by performing in an assortment of roles at local theaters. And it was in one of those plays that he caught the eye of a famous motion picture director, and the most unlikely of Hollywood careers began. Over the next few years, Burt began getting role after role in both movies and television, and like I said, he became a highly sought-after character actor because of his dependability and his humility. You see, selling hearing aids door to door, well, it has a way of humbling a man. Anyway, when Burt landed the role of Gus the Fireman on Leave It to Beaver, well, the chemistry between Mathers and Mustin was immediate and easy to see. To this day, Mathers has fond memories of Mustin and has called him a kind and gracious man that he enjoyed working with very much. And I have to believe that Mustin felt the same way about Mathers. You see, he and Robina never had children, and although each of the 15 appearances that he made on the show were scripted interactions between Burt and the Beef, you really can feel the warmth, dare I say it, the paternal affection that Gus had towards this young man. He just always had a way of finding the right thing to say to Beaver and whoever he might be with, and he always found a way to do it without talking down or being condescending. Gus often found a way to incorporate just a little bit of humor into his interactions with the Beef, always a critical thing to do when you're teaching an important life lesson. Burt's final appearance in Leave It to Beaver was in Season 5 in an episode titled Beaver's Fear. It's a fitting finale for Gus as he helps a now teenage Beaver overcome his fear of roller coasters. He does so by telling Beaver a story about rookie Gus the Fireman and a fear that he had to overcome. It's another touching moment that is made even more wonderful by Mustin's sincere performance. He was 78 years old when he filmed his last episode of Leave It to Beaver. Can you believe it? And Mustin was just getting started. After Leave It to Beaver, he made 14 appearances as Jud Fletcher, or a variation of the character, on The Andy Griffith Show, or one of its spin-offs. Again, Mustin knocked this role out of the park. Quite frankly, I don't think anyone could play an old man quite like Burt. Why? Well, most likely because he was one. Mustin was filming episodes for Andy Griffith well into his 80s. And on The Andy Griffith Show, Jud Fletcher, the character, was a stand-up guy who, along with Otis and Goob, at least at one time was duly deputized to serve and protect the citizens of Mayberry. Yep, just looking at this picture brings a smile to my face. At this point, it's likely you're starting to recall what an amazing actor Burt Mustin turned out to be as well. Maybe you remember him from an episode of Dragnet. He made multiple appearances on that show. He was, after all, a personal friend of Jack Webb's. Or maybe you remember that classic Brady Bunch episode where Burt plays the son of a man who the outlaw Jesse James gunned down from behind. Once again, Burt is setting young men straight as Bobby Brady has been idolizing the notorious outlaw in this particular episode. Or maybe you remember him from Get Smart, All in the Family, or Sanford and Son. Well, you get the idea. Burt was everywhere. Here's a screenshot from a 1974 appearance by Burt on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. I believe he was almost 90 when he made this appearance, and truthfully, Burt seemed every bit as sharp as he did during his early years in the business during the 50s and 60s. 3 years later, on January 28, 1977, Burt would pass away of natural causes at the ripe old age of 92. Sadly, the very next day, Freddie Prinz would pass away as well. Just like Burt was famous, at least in my mind, for being old, Freddie's fame and infamy was cemented in the Hollywood history books for dying young. Way too young. Maybe someday we'll talk more about Freddie, but today is not that day. Let's get back to Burt. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we were all as sharp-witted, in as fine of shape, and still have a great sense of humor the way that Burt did during his golden years? Rest in peace, my friend. Wherever you are now, I'm sure you're dispensing words of wisdom and making folks smile in equal doses. All right, now it's your turn. Please share your memories in the comments section, and while you're at it, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Maybe even share this video on Facebook or Twitter, and what the heck, why not subscribe to the channel? I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.